and welcome back to the Robot Games Camp. I am so excited to see you again today. As you may remember, my name is Audra, and I'm another one of your VEX Camp counselors. And in today's session, we are going to learn how to code our Clawbot. So far, we've driven our robots with the controller, but now we are going to learn how to move our robots without touching them at all, or without touching our controller. We're going to learn how to code our robots so that they can move autonomously just based on the code that we have written. It's really exciting. And to learn how to do that, we are going to play some basketball games with our robot. So first, we're going to learn how to code it to do some basketball drills where we're running back and forth down the court. And then we're going to build on what we learned to be able to code our robot to grab a basketball and shoot it and score it in a hoop. Now, as you can see from the things on my table, that basketball and hoop are going to be a little bit different, but that's okay. So before we get started and dive into coding, let's talk about the things that we will need for this session. So you're going to need your pre-built Clawbot that you have from your previous session. We're also going to need our charged IQ battery. You're going to need your IQ kit so that you can get out the USB cable that's in it, the same one that we use to charge our battery and our controller. We're going to use to connect our robot to VEXcode IQ. You're also going to need a device that you can run VEXcode IQ on. So we are going to be running the web-based version of VEXcode IQ. So you need a Chromebook or a computer or a laptop that has a Chrome-based browser so that you can see VEXcode IQ. Now, you may want to have that running on a separate device from whatever you're watching this video on, or in a separate window, so this way you can see what we're doing in camp and be able to follow along with your code as we're working. In addition to the VEXcode IQ things that we need, we'll need some things to set up our basketball game. So you'll need some tape or string to mark off some places on the floor. You're also going to need to measure those spaces, so you'll need a measuring tape or a meter stick or a yardstick. And then last but not least, we're going to need things to make our basketball. So we'll need some paper that we can crumple up to create some balls and a small box. Any box will do. I just grabbed one that I had on hand. Okay, now at this point, if you don't have any of those materials and you want to pause the video to go get them so you're ready for the whole session, you can do that. And just as a reminder, at any point in time, you can pause the video for whatever you need to do. You can rewind, replay, see things over again a few times, just to make sure that you're able to follow along to have the best camp experience possible. All right, who's ready to get started coding? I know that I am. So now the very first thing we're going to do to get started coding is we are going to learn about how to get to VEXcode IQ and how to connect our robot to it. So here I have my Clawbot. Now, if you don't already have your battery, your charged battery inserted in the brain, we want to make sure to do that. So again, we want to press that battery all the way in till we hear the click. Then we are going to turn on our brain. Now, this same cord that we use to charge the battery in the controller is the same cord that we're going to use to connect our robot to VEXcode IQ. So to do that, we're going to turn my Clawbot so you can see the side of the brain. That same side where we connect our battery has a little USB-C port. So we're going to plug the USB-C end of our cable into that port. Then we're going to connect the other end of this cable to whatever device we are using VEXcode IQ on. So here I have VEXcode IQ on my computer. So I'm going to plug the other end of this cord into my computer so that my robot and my computer are connected with this cord. So now I'm going to switch to the computer view so that you can see what I'm doing in VEXcode IQ. So the software that we're going to use to code our robot is called VEXcode IQ. And to get to VEXcode IQ, we're just going to open up our Chrome browser. And then here we're going to type codeiq.vex.com. So once again, that's codeiq.vex.com. So once you have that entered, it will open up and it should look just like this. If it's been a while or it's the first time you've ever been to Code IQ, you may get a little pop-up telling you about things that are new. You can just click close and then your workspace should look just like this. So the first thing we're going to do to get started is we are going to connect our robot, the brain, to VEXcode IQ. So up here in this top blue part, we call this the toolbar. You can see there's an icon for the controller and there's an icon for the brain. Since this is the first time we're doing this, it's a great idea for you to follow along with me as I'm clicking and dragging blocks into our project so that way you can do the same thing I'm doing at the same time. So to connect our brain, we're going to select that brain icon. It's going to open up. We can tell it's white, so nothing is connected. We also have this little reminder that's nothing connected. So we're going to click this button that says connect. Now it's telling us how we're going to connect to the brain. So all brains come with an ID number. So we're going to look for the brain that has the lowest number and select connect. So first we select continue. Then here we can see that there are some numbers here. This one has 01. This one has 03 at the end. So this is the smaller one. I'm going to select that one and click connect. Now my brain icon turns green, so I know that my brain and VEXcode are connected. Wonderful. So now you might be saying, okay, but now how do I make my robot move? I don't see anything over here that looks like it's about moving or driving. Well, that's because we have to tell VEXcode what kind of robot we're using so that it knows what kinds of things our robot can do. So the easiest way to do that is to open up a template. So we're going to go up to this file menu in the toolbar. We're going to go down to open examples. We're going to select that. Now up here, we can see where it says templates. If I select templates, now all I see are just the templates. So we're going to look for the one that matches our robot. We are using the Clawbot and has a drivetrain with two motors. So that's the one that we are going to select. We're going to select this Clawbot drivetrain two motor, and then that's going to open up. Whenever we open up a template or we add and configure things, now you can see we have some motion and some drive commands in our toolbox. Because VEXcode now knows what we have configured and all the ports that things are in, because we told it exactly what we were using and we built it from the build instructions. So all of the commands that we use are automatically configured and ready to go. So you can see that in this little note, which I'm going to close up for right now because I don't want to add anything to it. Okay, so now we've connected to VEXcode. We have our template set. We are ready to start to make our robot drive. So over here where all these blocks are, this is called our toolbox. So I'm going to scroll up in my toolbox till I get to this section called drivetrain, right? Because we want to make our robot drive. So we are going to use these drivetrain commands. So now the first command that we're going to use here is this drive for block. So this one right here that says drive forward for 200 millimeters. So I'm going to click that and drag it into the workspace. Then I'm going to drag it to connect it to the when started block. Did you hear that little click? When our projects run, they run from the when started block straight down in the order that we put those blocks in there. So our projects will run from top to bottom. So we have to make sure that all of our blocks are connected to each other and connected in the right order or sequence to make our robot do what we want it to do. So this block is going to make our robot drive forward for 200 millimeters. So now there are a few things in here that we can change, right? We can select this dropdown to make it drive in forward or in reverse. We can also change the distance that it's driving or the units that it's driving in. And we'll talk a little bit more about that later. But right now, I'm just really excited to see my robot drive. So in order to do that, I'm going to name this project. I'm going to select up here in this little name window and name my project Drive. Then I'm going to click Save. So I've built my project in VEXcode. I've named my project. Now I need to get that project onto my robot. So now I'm going to download it to the brain. So every time we make a change to our project or we add to our project, we always need to keep downloading it to the brain so that our project can run. So our robot is still connected, so I can see that this download button is available. So I'm going to click the download button. It's going to download my project to my robot's brain. So now I can disconnect my robot and I can set it on the floor anywhere. You can see I have some things set up here already, but we'll get to that in a minute. And now if we look, it should on your brain right now say the name of your project at the top, drive, and have a run option. So when we press the check mark, our project will start. We want to make sure there's nothing getting in the way of our robot so that it can move forward freely. So I'm going to press the check mark. You should do that too. It will calibrate for a moment. Congratulations, you just coded your robot to drive forward. Now our project is still running until we press the X button. So I'm gonna press the X button since it's done moving and it's done driving. Now if I wanted it to run that project again and go forward again, I could just press that check button. We'll see it calibrates for a moment and then it drives forward another 200 millimeters. Now, what if I wanted it to drive faster or to drive for a different distance or to drive backwards? I can code my robot to do all of those things. And we're going to learn about how to do all of those things in VEXcode IQ. All right, so now that we coded our robot to drive forward, now I'm gonna tell you a little bit about our very first coding challenge called basketball drills. If you've never run basketball drills in school or in a gym or in a club, I'm gonna tell you what they are. Basically, in a basketball court, there'd be a couple different markers and you have to run to the first one, run back, run to the second one that's further, run back, and then run to the last one that's the furthest, and then run back. So we're gonna code our robot to do just that. So in order to set that up, there's some things that we're going to need, right? This is your time to get your tape and your string and your measuring device. So I'm going to move my robot out of the way and show you how we're going to set up our basketball drills. So you're going to need to mark off four lines, a starting line, then one that's about 300 millimeters forward, another one at 600 millimeters, and a last one at 900 millimeters. You can also do this using inches and make them about 12 inches apart, but that distance is important because when we code our robot only does exactly what our code tells it to do. So we want to always know exactly how far our robot needs to move to get to the places that we want it to go. So we want to make sure that we're measuring pretty carefully and that we're setting up our starting lines, are 300 millimeters, 600 millimeters, and 900 millimeters. I labeled them just so this way they're easy for me to see and remember. Once you've done that, we're gonna set our Clawbot on the starting line with its front wheels on that starting point. And now we are going to learn how to code it to drive forward to the 300 and then back to the starting line. So I'm going to jump over to VEXcode IQ and you can do the same thing with me. So now we've coded our robot to drive forward for 200 millimeters, right? But our line here is at 300 millimeters. So we want to select this little bubble. This is called a parameter. And we're going to change the number by typing right into it to type 300 millimeters. Again, if you're using inches, you can change this to inches and then change that number to whatever your measurement is. So now that will take our robot forward to the 300 millimeters, but we need it to then go back to the starting line. So we need our robot to drive in reverse. So we're going to need another command right here. I bet you can guess what that will be. We're going to use another one of these drive for commands. We're going to change that parameter back to 300, but now let's take a look. It says drive forward for 300 and then drive, oops, we need it to say reverse, right? We want it to go backwards for 300. So now we're gonna do the same thing that we did before. We're gonna connect our robot back to VEXcode IQ. We're gonna plug in that cord into that same spot. Then we're going to select connect to reconnect our brain because every time we disconnect it, we have to reconnect it. We're gonna select that lowest number, click connect, and then download. So each time we change our project, we are going to need to re-download it to the brain because the projects run actually on the brain of our robot, not on our computer. So now I can unplug it. And then I can reset it back at my start line if you moved it. If not, great. So now here you can see this is our project. I'll make it a little bit bigger so it's easier to see. So there's our project. Our robot should drive forward to 300 and then back to the start. So let's see if it does that. I'm going to press that check button to start my project. And here we go. It's driving forward. Oh, it hit 300. And it went back. Congratulations, we did it. We just coded our robot to drive the first part of our basketball drills challenge. Awesome, we just coded the very first part of our basketball drills. So now what is the next part that we're going to have to code of this basketball drills challenge, right? We coded it to go to 300 millimeters and back. Then the next piece of our project is to code it to go to 600 millimeters and back. And then the third part of our project is to go to 900 millimeters and back to the start. Now that might be a lot of things for you to keep in your head. Well, we can use some things in VEXcode IQ to help us break down our project so it's a little bit easier to organize. So let's go take a look over at VEXcode IQ again, and I'll show you just how to do that. So in VEXcode IQ, in my toolbox, all the way down here, I have this little gray bubble that says comments. So I can drag a comment block into my project, and then I can label what this part of my project is all about. These comment blocks are gray. They don't cause our robot to do anything. They are just there for us to be able to keep track of and organize our project. So what did this first part of our project do? This caused our robot to drive to and from 300 millimeter line. There we go, it drove to the first part. So now I can put comments in for the next two parts of my project, right? The next thing I want it to do is drive to and from the 600 millimeter line. And then the last thing that I want it to do is to drive to and from the 900 millimeter line. So now I know all of the things that I want to do. And you might be saying, but wait, Audra, there's gonna need to be some blocks in between there. Yes, there are going to need to be blocks in between there. And I can drag blocks in and stick them right in the middle of my project. If I wanna move things around, I can detach blocks and leave them floating around there. I can slide them up and around in my project. I can move chunks of blocks in my project. I can put them back. And then if I dragged in a block that I don't wanna use anymore, I can just slide it back over to the toolbox, let it go, and it's gone and it's deleted. So now you have your project set up to be able to add more commands to drive to and from 600 millimeters and to and from the 900 millimeter line by driving your robot forward and reverse. So now your challenge is to drive your robot forward and reverse to complete this whole basketball drills challenge. Okay, so you want to make sure that your space is set up, that you've marked off 300 millimeter increments, and that your robot always starts with its wheels on that starting line, right? Because it's going to go an exact distance, so we need to make sure it starts in the same place. So we've coded the first one together. So now you are going to go add to your project, download it, run it, test it. You can download it just in small pieces. Every time you add a block, you can test your project. Okay, just like we tested one block and then two blocks, you can do that very same thing. So you are going to go and complete the basketball drills challenge, then you're going to come back here and I'm going to show you another trick that we can do. Okay, congratulations, you did it. Now you may be wondering, wait a minute, my robot's moving kind of slow. It moved a lot faster when I used my controller, right? I could change the speed of my robot. Well, guess what? You can change how fast your robot runs its basketball drills in code also. Let me show you the block that does that just in case you want to use it. So over here in my toolbox, I have this set drive velocity block. Our drive velocity for our robot is always set to a default 50%. But if I want to make it go faster, I can drag that set drive velocity block up to the very top of my project, and then I can change that number and make it higher. I can make it 75% or 80% or even 100%. And that will make my robot drive faster. Now, there are some things to think about, though, when we're driving faster. And I bet you remember when you were driving really fast with your controller, it was a little bit harder. You had a little less precision when you were driving your robot with your controller. So the same thing is true when we're driving our robot with code. The faster it goes, we lose a little bit of that precision. So sometimes we may want to go really fast. Sometimes we might not. And sometimes we might want to just go a little bit faster. So we always want to think about the balance between speed and precision in what we're doing. But that block is there in case you want to use it. So now we've driven our robot forward and reverse. But if you were running basketball drills, you wouldn't run forward and then run backwards, right? You would run forwards, turn around, and then run back, right? So that we're always facing forward. So the next challenge we're going to do with basketball drills is to code our robot to do that same challenge, but only driving forward. So to do that, we're going to need to learn how to code our robot to drive forward, then turn, and then drive forward again. So now let's take a look at VEXcode IQ so we can learn about how to make our robot drive and turn. So here I'm going to just move these blocks after the first one over to the side. So this way I can keep working on this stack, but I want to save them because I'm going to use them again. So you can drag them off here. If you have disconnected blocks in your workspace, they won't run when your project is downloaded. Only the things that are connected to this when started block will run. So we always want to make sure that the things that we want to run when we start our project are connected over here. So now I still have this drive forward for 300 millimeters, but I want my robot to drive forward and then turn. So now I'm going to grab a turn for block. So right here, I have this little turn right for 90 degrees. So let's talk real quickly about where 90 degrees is. So if my robot is facing forward and it turns 90 degrees, you might remember this from math class, 90 degrees is exactly a right triangle. It's one turn this way. But I want my robot to turn all the way around. So I want it to go another 90 degrees. So when it goes from front to back to turn all the way around, that's 180 degrees. So now here, I want to change this turn right to 180 degrees. Now I can make my robot turn left or right. Since I'm just turning around, it doesn't really matter the direction, you can choose. But sometimes it will, right? If we're trying to code our robot to travel on a maze or to get to a specific location, we always want to pay attention to left or right. So for right now, I just want my robot to drive to and from that 300 millimeter line, but always staying forward. So I'm going to drive it forward for 300 millimeters. We're going to turn right for 180 degrees, and then I'm going to drive back to the starting line. So I'm going to snag that block from over here, but now I'm going to change that back to forward. So now I'm going to download this project again. Now again, the only part that's going to run are these blocks that are over here. So I'm going to plug in the cord to connect my brain with the cord. Now I'm going to connect my brain in VEXcode. We're going to follow that same step, select the lower number, click connect. I see it's connected. Then I'm going to select download. Now I've downloaded that project. So now I can disconnect the cord. I can put my robot back on the starting line again with the wheels on my tape. And now when I press the check mark to start my project, it's going to drive forward to the 300, turn around, and then drive back to the starting line. Exactly, that's exactly what I want my robot to do. Now to get ready to drive to the 600 millimeter line, what will it need to do? It will need to turn around again, that 180 degrees, and then repeat that process, right, of driving forward and coming back. Now that my robot's done moving, I can press the X to stop my project. Now before we move on any further, we do want to make sure that we're saving our projects to our device. So this way we have them as we're moving forward. So if I go back to VEXcode IQ, I've named my project Drive. I want to go to the File menu and click Save to your device. So now it will download a copy of this project directly to my device. So you may get a prompt to change that location depending on the device that you're using, but we always want to make sure that we're saving our project so this way we have a copy of it ready to go so that way we can keep working on it and adding to it. So periodically as we're working, we want to save our projects. Now, one more thing before you go off to code your own basketball drills driving forward. Just like we had a drive velocity block, we also have a turn velocity block. So we, in order to set our robot to drive and turn more quickly if we want to, or more slowly if you want to, we need to drag the set turn velocity and set drive velocity block. And then here again, you can also change that from 50 to whichever number you want between 0 and 100. So the lower the number, the slower it goes, the higher the number, the faster it goes. So those blocks are there for you to be able to use as well. So now we've coded our robot to complete the first 300 millimeters only driving forward. So your challenge is to code your robot to do the next two parts of this challenge, right? To code it to drive to 600 meters and then to 900 meters and back, but with no reverse. So make sure you watch your parameters and have fun coding. Once you code your robot to do those things, come on back here and we will get ready for the next part of our session. Hello and welcome back. So now that you have coded your Clawbot to complete all of the basketball challenges and you know how to code your robot to move around the court autonomously, now we're ready to level up our coding a little bit so that way we can code our robot to shoot and score our basketballs into their hoop. So let's talk about what we're going to do in this robot basketball challenge. First of all, we're going to use the same setup of our spaces and our lines of tape that we had from our basketball drill. So you can leave that the same. But now we're going to add some things to it. So this is where we're going to need that box that we were talking about. And you're going to need two balls made of paper. So I just took some extra scrap paper, two or three sheets, and balled them up to create a basketball. We just want to make sure that the ball is big enough that it can easily be fit inside of the claw and be grabbed and lifted. If it's too small, it might be a little tricky. So you can use any objects in your house to be the balls, any kind of paper, but we just want to make sure that we have two of them. Then in the basketball challenge, what we're going to code our robot to do is to drive, pick up basketballs, and score them inside of the hoop as quickly as possible. So we're going to try to code our robot to collect two basketballs, shoot them into the hoop as fast as possible. But before we can get to that challenge, we need to learn a couple more things, right? We know how to code our robot to drive on the court, but we don't yet know how to code our claw to grab a basketball or our arm to lift it above the edge of the box so it can go in the hoop. So that's what we are going to focus on first. The very first thing we're going to do is think about how we can code this claw to grab that basketball so that way we know we've got a good hold on our ball so we can get ready to shoot it into the hoop. So now we're going to jump back over into VEXcode so we can talk about the commands that we use to control the claw motor. Okay, so here I am in VEXcode and you can see that I still have my drive program open from when I was running the basketball drills. Your project probably looks somewhat similar to this. It might look a little bit different. One of the great things about coding is that there are a lot of different ways to solve the same challenge. So if you're looking for a little inspiration, you can look at what is happening here in this project. But what we're going to do right now so that we can get ready to play robot basketball is we are going to open a brand new project. So I've gone ahead and made sure that I saved this project. So that way I have it if I want to play basketball drills again or work on that code. But here I'm going to go up to the file menu in the toolbar and select new blocks project. If you haven't saved your project, you'll get prompted to save it then, which you can do. So now when I open up my brand new blocks project, we can see again, just like we saw before, we've now lost those motion and drivetrain blocks. Well, that's because in a brand new project, VEXcode doesn't know what robot we are using, right? We haven't configured anything or told it what we have. So we're going to go and follow the same process we did before. Let's see how much you remember. So first we need to open up the file menu. Then we're going to go to, you got it, open examples. And then up here, we're going to select templates. And now we are using the Clawbot with a two-motor drivetrain. So we want to find the template that says Clawbot drivetrain two-motor. That's right here. So we're going to grab that template. And now all of those blocks that we were using in the previous project are back. So for basketball drills, we focused on these drivetrain blocks. But when we're learning about the arm and the claw, we're going to focus on these motion blocks up here. So I'm going to close up this note for now. And just the same way we did with our drive project, we want to make sure that we name this project as well. So I'm going to call this Robot Basketball, since that is the name of the challenge, and select saved. So now we've opened up our new project, we've configured it, we have named our robot. So now what blocks can we use to control the claw motor? We're going to start with just the claw, and this very first block up here that says spin claw motor, we're going to grab that and drag that into our new project. So here, this block is talking about spinning this claw motor closed. So we can change this parameter from closed to open. So that way we can change the direction that our claw moves from closed to open. We can also change this from claw motor to arm motor, but right now we're just focusing on the claw. So now that we have our claw motor block, our spin claw motor block in our project, we're going to download this project just so that way we can test our claw motor. So I'm going to make sure that my robot's brain is on. I'm going to plug my robot back in again using that same USB-C cable as before. I'm going to plug that back in, and then over in VEXcode IQ, I'm going to connect the brain once again. And this is just reminding me to choose the one with the lowest number. So here I have 301 is lower than 303. So I'm going to select that. My brain is connected, and now I can download my project. So I've downloaded my project. So now let's get this set up together. So now I'm going to disconnect that cord, right? And all I'm doing here is just focusing on the claw motor. So it doesn't matter where I put my robot, and I'm going to kind of pre-feed it this ball. I'm going to just hand it the ball. I'm going to put the ball right there in between the claw. And then when I press the check mark to run my project, the claw motor will spin. And now we can see that the claw motor is holding it. So if I very gently lift that arm, I can see that my claw motor is spinning closed. Now, we never told our claw motor to stop, so it's going to constantly spin to hold that ball. Just like if you were holding a basketball, right? If you were holding your basketball, you would keep holding it, right? You wouldn't let go. You wouldn't loosen your hands so that it falls down. You just keep holding it. So that's what our claw motor is doing right now. So now that we know that that's working, I'm going to press the X button. You can do that as well. And now let's talk about what we need to do next. So now part of the robot basketball challenge is to score our balls in our hoop. So now I'm also going to need, if I look at this, right, I've got my basket, I've got my basketball, I can hold it in the claw, but I need to get it over the edge of my basket, right? Because now it's still on the floor. So I need to be able to lift the arm of the robot up so that I can put it into the basket. So you just want to make sure that your box is not taller than your robot. Right? So we want a kind of a small box, just like what I have here. So now how far do I need to move my arm, or what do I need to know about the arm in order to code it? So we're going to code the arm using a block called spin to position, which is going to spin this motor to a specific position that will move the arm to a different height. So the different positions signify different heights of the arm. When it's all the way down at its lowest point, it's at position zero, right? That makes sense. It's on the bottom. But when, as we raise it, that position will get higher, and all the way up at the top will be about position 250. So we can code our robot to move anywhere between zero and 250. So that's what we're going to use right now, because we know that if we are all the way up, there's no way we're not going to make that basket, right? So we're going to use that 250, which is the uppermost point of our arm movement, and zero is the lowest. So zero will be what we need to grab a ball. 250 is what we need to shoot the ball. Okay, so let's go find out what block we're putting those values into. So now if I come back here to my robot basketball project, I'm going to make these blocks a little bigger so they're easier for you to see. Now I'm going to grab this block right here that says spin to position. So I'm going to drag that block in. Now here, just like this first one, I can change this from the claw motor to the arm motor. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to change this block to the arm motor. And now we said we want to lift it all the way up to the top. So I'm going to change that position to 250. So now what are we coding our robot to do? We're telling our robot that it's going to spin that claw motor closed to hold onto the basketball. Then we're going to spin the arm motor up in order to lift it so that it's ready to shoot the ball. So now if I bring my robot back over, I'm going to download this project once again. So I'm going to plug it back in. I'm going to connect my brain one more time, following those same steps. Connect with the lowest number and then select download. So now it will download. So now when I unplug my cord from my robot, I can set up a little test run here, right? So again, I'm going to make sure my claw starts open so I can feed it the ball, because we're just testing now, right? We don't want to pick it up from anywhere. We just want to learn how to use it. So I'm just going to test it. Now, when I press the check mark button, my claw will close and it raises. And now if I test this out, I can see that my box moves underneath there really easily. So I know that I'll be able to score. So now I'm going to press the export button to stop that project. And then you can see that stops all the motors from running. So my ball is dropped. So now let's set up a little bit of a test trial here. So we're going to start with our robot on the starting line, just like we had it before. And we're going to put our hoop on the 300 line, just for ease, just to keep this very simple for us. We're going to move that to 300. So we're going to do the same thing that we were doing before. We're going to run this project again and see if it shoots the ball. So if I press the check mark, I'm going to start it and let's see what happens. Grabbed the ball, lifted the ball, but now what do I need? Well, now I need to drive my robot forward so that I can shoot the ball into the hoop. So now we're going to take what we learned previously, were basketball drills, and we're going to combine that together with what we know about the arm and the claw. So we can grab the ball, lift the ball, drive to the hoop, and shoot it into our hoop. So let's go back to VEXcode to see what that will look like in our project. Okay, so now we're going to add one of our drivetrain blocks to our project so that we can drive to the hoop. So we're going to use that same drive four block that we used for basketball drills. And we know that from basketball drills that we're driving forward for 300 millimeters. So we want to change that parameter to 300. So now if we look at the sequence that we've built here, we're spinning that claw motor closed to grab the ball. Then we're spinning the arm motor up to lift the ball, and then we're driving forward to the hoop. So now we should be able to score our first basket. So I'm going to plug in my robot, again, using that USB-C cord, and I'm going to download this project, and then we're going to see if we can score our very first basket together. So again, we're going to select continue, and the lowest number that appears, we'll click connect. We're connected. Now we need to download. Okay. So now when I unplug my robot and move it back to the start line, and I want to make sure my wheels are on the start line, right? Because we are not controlling our robot. So we need to make sure our robot's doing exactly what we tell it to do. So we want to set it up for success. I'm always going to start with my claw open. And for this, since this is just a test of a score, I'm going to give it the ball first. We don't need to track it around. We're going to start on the court with the ball. So now we press the check mark. Are you ready? Let's see if our robot scores. Okay, it's calibrating, and now we grab the ball. We lifted it. We drove to the hoop. What happened? It didn't shoot. Why not? Because we never told the claw to open again. Oh, my goodness. So now we're going to stop that project. We need to add another block to our project, right? Our robots only do exactly what we tell them to do. And we told our robot to hold on to that ball. We never told it to spin it open again in order to release the ball. So we need to add another block to our project. So we're gonna add another one of these spin commands right down here. We wanna spin the claw motor, but now instead of spinning it closed, we wanna spin it open. So now our sequence says to grab the ball, lift the ball, drive to the hoop, and drop the ball. Open up that claw and shoot the ball. So now we're gonna download that project once again. We'll plug in our robot. We'll connect the brain. We will select continue, the lowest number, and download. Okay, so now that my project is downloaded, I can disconnect my robot and set it up. And now let's see if we can score our very first robot basketball basket. That will be super exciting, don't you think? Okay, so I've fed my robot the ball. I'm checking to make sure my setup is right. My basket is right on the 300 line. My robot's wheels are right on the start line, so I know I'm ready to go. Now, when I press the check mark, here we go. Let's see. Drives forward. Drops the ball. It shoots. It scores. You did it. Congratulations. We just scored our very first basket in the robot basketball challenge. So now I'm going to press the X button here to stop my project from running. Now, let's talk about how we can use what we just did in order to build a project to actually play the robot basketball challenge. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you how that's set up, and you can follow along with me again to set up your robot basketball challenge, and then we'll show you how we're going to code our robot to do that, right? So now we've run up and down the court, we know how to shoot a basket, now we're going to put all of that together in order to be able to play the game. So very simply, again, using the same lines from basketball drills because we know where they are, our robot is going to start on the 300 millimeter line for robot basketball. We're going to place our basket on the 900 millimeter line. I'm going to move my computer a little bit so that it fits here. I want to make sure the edge of the basket is on that line. And then we're going to place our two balls. One is going to be in front of the robot on the 600 millimeter line, and one is going to be behind the robot. Now, the goal of the robot basketball challenge is for you to code your robot to grab, lift, and score both balls as fast as possible. So before we get started coding that, we want to think about what kinds of things our robot is going to need to do, right? There's a little bit of strategy here. Right, we can grab these balls in any order, but which one should we start with? Well, we could start with the one behind the robot, right, and grab that one and get it out of the way and start with our robot and go turn around and grab that ball and then turn around and drive it back. But then what will happen? Oh no, we'll probably run into this ball, or we need to code our robot to drive all the way around it, and that's not going to be real fast. And if we knock into this ball and it goes rolling, we won't be able to find it autonomously. So strategy-wise, we probably want to start with this ball that's in front of the robot right here. So let's talk about what we need to do. What are the steps that we're going to need now that we know that we're going to get that first, that ball that's right in front of the robot first? So what are the things that we need to do in order to build this project, right? We're going to need to code our robot to drive, grab, and lift the first ball, then drive, open the claw, and score that first ball. Then we're going to need to code our robot to lower the arm, turn around, and go get the next ball. And then we're going to need to code our robot to grab the second ball, turn around, lift it, and drive to score it, right? So that's all the things we need to do. We kind of had four big items, right? So we'll break up our project into four sections. So let's do that the same way we did before with the basketball drills. We're going to do that with comment blocks in our project just to make it a little bit easier for us to keep track of what it is that we're coding. So let's jump back into VEXcode IQ so we can add some comments to our project and get started on this challenge. So now I'm going to just move these blocks off to the side here because we might want to use some of them again. But I'm going to select that comment so that I can drag some comments into my project. So here I'm going to add 4 comment blocks. I'm going to add one that says, I'm going to click into that space. And now I'm going to add a comment that says that I want to drive, grab, and lift the first ball. Then I'm going to add a second comment that says that I want to score the first ball in the basket, right? That's what we're going to do next. And then the next piece of my project here is to turn around and go get the second ball, right? Turn and drive to grab the second ball. And then the very last thing we're going to do is to score the second ball in the basket. Okay. So now let's think about what we need to do for this very first part. We've done some of these behaviors already, but now let's think about what we need to do, right? We need to be able to drive forward to get the ball. So how far do we need to drive? We need to drive forward about 300 millimeters, right? That will make sure that we get from the 300 line to the 600 line. So that's the first block we're going to add. Is we are going to drive forward, and I'm going to stick that right in between there. Drive forward for 300 millimeters. And then I want to grab that ball, right, and lift it. Well, that's the same thing that we did before with the spinning the claw motor closed and spinning the arm to lift it. So I'm going to separate these blocks down here, and I'm going to reuse these same ones from before and just slide those right in there. So now, do we have the commands to drive, grab, and lift the first ball? We're driving, we're grabbing, and then we're lifting that very first ball. So now let's download this project just so that way we can test it, right? It's always a little bit easier as we're building projects to test them in smaller increments. It makes it simpler. If something doesn't go the way that we want it to go, we have many fewer blocks to be able to check to see what's wrong, right? Maybe we don't have the right parameter. Maybe we don't have the right direction. So I'm going to plug my robot in again and connect the brain and download my project. So we'll set continue, that lower number, connect, and now download. So now when I disconnect the cord and I can make sure that my robot basketball setup is ready to go. So here we go, let's take a look. So my robot is here, its wheels are starting on the line, my ball is at the 600 millimeter line, and my basket is at the 900 millimeter line. So now when I start my project, let's see what happens. We're trying to grab the ball, lift the ball. So now we did that first part. Now what's the next step that we need to do? We need to score that first ball in the basket. So what are we going to need to do next? We're going to need to drive forward another 300 millimeters and then open that claw to drop the ball. So now I can stop my project, catch the ball, put it back here, and let's go add to the second part of our project. So now we need to drive forward another 300 millimeters and open the claw. That's just what we did when we were testing. So we can use these same blocks and drag them right here in between these 2 comments. So you'll see you get a little gray outline that shows you where the blocks are going to go when you're dragging them. If they ever don't go where you want, that's fine. You can just disconnect and move things around in any order that you want. It makes it very, very easy. So now, do we have our blocks in the right order to do what we want it to do? We know that this first top part worked. Now let's see if we've got our drive for and spin command in the right order as well. So again, we're going to test in small increments. So I'm going to plug my robot in. I'm going to connect to the brain. I'm going to connect to the lower number and then download my project. And now let's see if we can score our very first basket in the basketball challenge. Okay, so now let's test this project, right? We see we've gotten our first two comments of our project complete. So let's see if we can actually score the first ball in the basketball challenge. So I can make sure that my wheels are on my line here on the 300 millimeter line. My ball is set up. My first ball is set up at 600 millimeters. You want to make sure that you're setting it up across from your claw, since, and if you need to move it a little bit, you can. That's fine. And my basket is at 900 millimeters. All right, are we ready? Let's start our projects together. 3, 2, 1, check mark. Let's see what happens. We drove forward. We're grabbing the ball. We lifted the ball. We're going to the hoop. We shoot, we score. All righty. We just did our very first score in the robot basketball challenge. So now I'm going to press the X button to stop my project. Now, what do we need to do next? What you are going to do as you try to solve the rest of this challenge is you're going to get ready to get that next ball. So we ended with our arm all the way up here. So think about what you're going to need to do to complete those next two comments, to turn and drive and grab the next ball, right? We need to turn and drive. We're probably going to lower our arm at some point. We need to go get that ball and turn around and drop it off in the hoop. Now we're trying to do this as fast as possible. So I wonder if you remember one of the tricks we talked about at basketball drills for how to make your robot move faster. There's that set velocity block, right? So we can set the drive velocity and the turn velocity to be a little bit higher. Now you might notice if you set that to 100%, it makes your robot move with a little bit less precision. So you want to make sure that you're balancing out that precision with the speed so that you get your best possible chance at completing the robot basketball challenge. So now that we've coded together to score the first ball, it's your job to add onto that code in order to score the second ball and have a complete robot basketball challenge. So before we break to do that, let's make sure that we've saved our project so that way you know that you have a good start to your project to work from. So we're going to go back to VEXcode IQ. We're going to go up here to our file menu and select Save to Your Device. So now I know that I have the start of my robot basketball project saved. And as I'm adding to it and building onto it, I want to make sure that I'm saving often and regularly as I get parts of my project set that I know are working the way I want them to. So now that we've seen how to save your project, and we talked about how you might want to reopen your project to edit it or to run it again, I'm going to show you real quickly how to do that. So in order to load a project that you've saved to your device, you're going to go back up to the file menu in the toolbar. We'll select the file menu and then go down to load from your device. Now, depending on what kind of device you are running VEXcode IQ on, this might look a little bit different from yours, but here you can see that here are the projects that I have downloaded to my device. Here's my robot basketball project we were just using, and I have two versions of my drive program, the first one that I saved and then the final project that I saved. So here you can see it has a little number one to show you that it's the same project, but it's a copy of it. So I'm going to reopen that drive project. And then when I do that, here you can see here's our final basketball drills project, or at least my version of the final basketball drills project. And that's it. We can see that it's named up here, drive one. If you save it multiple times, you may end up with more numbers afterwards. That's fine. Or you can rename your project. But either way, that's how you would load that file in order to open it back up to be able to edit your project or run your project again. So now that your project is saved, you know how to score the first ball, you have all the tools that you need to score the second one, go forth and score in that robot basketball challenge. And once you've built that project, come on back and we'll talk about some things that we can do to have an extra challenge or a little bit of extra fun as we get ready for our session 5. All right, so did you score all the balls? I wonder how fast was your fastest time. Now, there are some other things that we can do to kind of expand this challenge, right? I've had so much fun trying to score these basketballs. But what if there were more basketballs on the field, right? You can grab some more paper and add more balls in different locations and see if you can code your robot in order to collect them. You could also try something really neat and try to do this very same challenge using your controller and see which one is faster. Are you faster at scoring in the basketball challenge when you're using your controller? Or is your robot actually faster with code? That would be a really interesting thing to kind of check out and see. You can also challenge some other people in your family or in your class or some friends to see how fast they are playing robot basketball. Can they build code in order to do it? Can they drive their robot faster than your code can move your robot? There's a lot of different ways that we can play this game. We can move the location of the hoop and then have a new challenge. We can make our hoop smaller so that we have a smaller location to go to. So there's a bunch of different things that you can do if you want to keep playing robot basketball, if you're having a great time. If you're ready to get ready for session 5, you can ask your parent or your teacher to take a look at the parent guide with you, because there is some information about what you will need and how you will need to set up your space for the Section 5 challenge. It's going to be so much fun. We're going to code our robot. We're going to drive our robot. We're going to do all kinds of neat things to play a fantastic game. And if you want to get a jump on that Session 5 activity, you may want to find your materials and get your game space set up ahead of time. So once you're done playing robot basketball, if you want to get a head start on that, you can take a look at that parent guide with your grown-up, and together you can find the things that you need and make sure that you are ready to go for Session 5. Well, I have had a blast playing robot basketball with my Clawbot. I hope that you have too, and I can't wait to see you in another session of Robot Games Camp.